how might I adjust an assignment that I currently have for the online environment quickly? So I teach communication. So my students do a lot of speeches in my courses. So it's harder to do speeches online. How could I adjust a speech or a group presentation at the end? And I just want to give you some examples of how you might adjust for just one assignment. So if I was going to do an in-class oral presentation, how could I adjust it to meet this learning modality? I could say, we're still doing in-class presentations and we're going to do them via Zoom. And here's the times that you're doing and here's who's evaluating them. And we're going to do it very similar to what we would do. We're just going to do it via a different digital method. I could say instead, we're not going to do the presentations because we're not doing any synchronous sessions, but everybody can annotate their PowerPoint slides and submit those to an assignment in our LMS. I could say, no, I want to think outside the box. Instead of doing a presentation, I know digital tools are really important in presentations, so I want everyone to create an infographic of the oral presentation you would have done, share them on the discussion board, and we'll all talk about them. I could have that student lead a discussion board on the topic that they were going to do their oral presentation on. So instead of giving an oral presentation, you're going to lead the discussion board that week and maybe have a couple going at the same time, and then you give all your peers feedback. Maybe I have my students pre-record their speeches and upload them using a tool like Screencast-O-Matic into the learning management system. Now, again, I might be the only one that sees those unless I have them upload them into the discussion board and then tell each of the students you have to watch three speeches and give them feedback. I could just forgo the speech and say instead it's a paper now. Or I could have the students do speeches, but instead of doing them digitally and having to switch from presenter to presenter, I have them do in groups. The thing is that we have a lot of ways that we can adjust our assignments, and it takes creativity to say in this very short amount of time without the help of an instructional designer, what might I do to change my assignment so that I can meet the needs of my students and know that they're still understand the elements of effective oral presentation. All right. And then finally, I would be remiss if I didn't say something about discussion boards, which I think are kind of like they're the staple of online learning, because it's a way to build that connection and community that our students so desperately need, especially right now as they might be feeling concerned or anxious, not just about COVID-19, but about not being there with you and about their learning. So I love discussion boards as a way to build community. So my good friend, Don Tharp, who is an adjunct faculty at Ashland University and our director of information technology, did a presentation on how to write a great discussion board question. And I asked him if I could use his information and share it with all of you. And he said, absolutely. But one of the things he said about discussion board questions is certainly you can do those that build connection, like what was one fabulous thing that you did over spring break, or what was one good experience you had, or post a picture that represents how you're feeling right now, whatever it is. But as we think about discussion board questions, how can we frame those so it extends the conversation outside of class, which is what a good discussion board is supposed to do? And remember, it's very easy in your learning management system to click the link that says students have to write their post before they're allowed to read anybody else's. If you don't click that, what I find is I get 24 or 30 answers that all sound exactly the same. So click that link, make everybody answer the question before they can read anybody else's. But he gives you some great examples on here, like how do you encourage higher level thinking in it? So you could have them watch a video and then say, you just watched this clip of this video. How does that video pertain to the following theory that we've been studying? Or considering you just read and discussed the fall of Mordor this past week, can you summarize the effects of teamwork on Frodo's success in it? Whatever it is, how can you word the question so that you're really getting them to apply the content in there? I think you can also, another great way to do a discussion board is to allow students to lead the discussion board with your assistance, because you're going to be present. They need to see you there. But Zoom's a great option if you want to bring in a guest speaker and then have the students comment on that on the discussion board if you're only using that 40-minute version. And then certainly, I love to put the students in small groups of four or five and make them really analyze a concept together. And then that means as a faculty, I might be managing 7 discussion boards that week. But sometimes if you get 30 people, the threads get very long and nobody really gets that like in-depth connection that they do in those other ways. All right. And that brings us back to where we started with communication. So we looked at a little bit about online learning. We looked at 6 strategies to communicate effectively with our students in this new environment. We looked at some synchronous and asynchronous ways to deliver the content. We looked at what kind of activities, how we might adjust those, how we could use discussion boards, what might come with our publisher's content, what's already created for us. So we looked at all of these kinds of things. How do we prioritize? And it brings us back to communication. And I shared at the very beginning of this presentation, this Mary Ellen Wymer book on learner-centered teaching. And the one question that she asks in this book that I constantly ask my students in an online environment is this: how did this impact your learning? So students might love a synchronous lecture or hate it. They might enjoy a discussion board or not like it. But I always ask them that question: how is this impacting your learning? How is this helping you learn? What did you learn by doing this activity? So coming back around to that communication. If your students didn't watch your videos, following up with them. If they didn't fully answer the discussion board question, reaching out to them. Building those kinds of real and deep connections.